Hello, everybody. My name is Hop Yu. I'm an energy healer, healing people and the planet. How is everybody today? I hope you're all happy and safe. Today, I'm releasing some very special original information on four countries, starting with Malaysia, Indonesia, Australia, and Norway. It is a very special kind of energy analysis I made to understand the situation in my country, and then I extended the study to three other countries for comparison. Although the situation in my country is causing a lot of concern to me, and I had done some energy transformation work for the country, and I need some baseline data. And the data I got is by connecting to the divine. And what I got shocked me, but also explains a lot of things in my own country, as well as in Australia, Indonesia, and Norway. I chose Indonesia because it is very similar to my country in the important parameters. But in the last 5 years, Indonesia has made so much positive progress and is now overtaken my country in various aspects like economic and even in its policies and politics. We will see the data in a moment. I then took a look into Australia because of its interesting policies, and I decided to look into Norway because I think many people, I think the majority, knows very little about that country. So it will be an interesting case study and comparison. There are also some other related background information that I need to convey. And it is the following. The first point is that those with negative vibration will in fact choose to protect the very system that enslaved them. Second point, these negative people will also support and propagate tyranny, violence, separation, division, and fear narratives. The third point is that there are also non-humans and humanoid invaders from other dimensions that are implementing anti-human agendas and programs here. Fourth point, besides the depopulation agendas, there's also running concurrently the dehumanization programs in the hybridization projects to hijack the human DNA, which is very powerfully encoded in humans. The fifth point, actually, these followers of the Black Sun seek to destroy completely the human DNA and to push for vaccination programs is the final battle over humanity. The sixth point is that the breaking of the 3D matrix will lend many low vibrational people to complete insanity. This is what I foresee. There will be a jump in suicides. So to avoid these, my friends, people of the world, you must be awakened as soon as possible. So, what is my main message today? The main message here is for the population to quickly be awakened and save yourself and your family. In extension, your country. Don't propagate the lies or be lied to and start to vibrate with good, positive thoughts to change to a better timeline for you and your family and your country. Make the 100th monkey effect to break the hold of the liars, the crooks of the country, the racist agenda of the politicians, and so on. I will now explain a little what is the 100th monkey effect, in case you are not too sure. It is a scientific fact, and it was reported in the journals about some scientists, while observing a troop of monkeys, saw that these monkeys was washing the potatoes in the pond. This animal behavior is not seen elsewhere at that time. And not long after that, in about, I think, more than 100 kilometers away, or more, another group of monkeys were observed doing the same thing. And then there were reports from other observers about troops of monkeys washing their food, whatever, in rivers, streams, and ponds. So there is no way one troop of monkey could migrate to the other troop because it was pretty far. So the only conclusion the scientists can have is that somehow these monkeys who were thinking and doing the process of washing their food in the ponds, their thoughts were caught up by another group of monkeys quite far away and so on. And the other groups caught on the idea somehow. You know, monkeys don't have internet. So this is called the 100th monkey effect. Then this is a very important concept because when you project a thought, positive or negative, this thought, which is energy, is transmitted to the universe. And it can be caught or downloaded by some other people. So just to emphasize on what I've been talking about, let me share my screen. So this is from the Theologians. It says, no, children of the earth, that you are several billion inhabitants on this planet, and that those who manipulate you are only a handful. You can annihilate them just by your thoughts of longing for peace and love. Let emerge from the depths of your being, from your heart, an infinite quantity of thoughts of love and peace. Visualize that you are pure light moving on this beautiful planet and offering all of your radiance to it. Imagine the wonderful and very powerful impact it will have if all humans, at least a very part of you, do the same thing. So this is the importance of emanating positive thoughts. You can help change your country. You can help change the world. Now, just a little bit of an example of positive thinking in action. Let's take a question. Let's say, will the convicted criminal who is still free to roam about in the country be thrown into jail? If you are a negative thinker, you would say, no one can touch him. But if you are a positive thinker, you will say and think, of course, he will soon be thrown in jail. So if the positive thinker then multiply his thought via the mechanism of the 100 monkey effect and make others think the same thing, this timeline for the criminal to be thrown in jail will be manifested. So just before showing you these statistics, let's see the headlines of one of our news portal that has been published on the 25th of March to emphasize how grave the situation in my country, Malaysia. So I shall now share the screen and let's go down to the headlines. This is the headline published on the 25th of March. It's do or die for Malaysia. Yet foolish Malaysians don't realize it. If Najib bin Rosmah returned to power, imagine the vengeance. Imagine the changes they will make to ensure no one ever catches them again for thievery. Even now, MECC, that is our anti-corruption agency, is silent despite shocking evidence revealed in the US courts about Rosmah's pink diamond. Well, enough said. So before I show you the statistics, as I use a lot of my own terminology, I like to tell you the definition so that you can understand the statistics better. So these are the five definitions that I would like to talk about. The first definition of light workers. These are boots on the ground, people who carry out projects for the light. They are mostly star seeds incarnated here, but many are still dormant, do not know the mission that they're supposed to do on Earth. and not activated fully in the skills, the special skills they possess. Also, sad to say, many had been infiltrated by dark forces, and therefore only 0.3% of them are really functional. One reason of the depopulation agenda by the cabal is to reduce the population of these light workers. Another term I use in the stats is dark souls. They are very dangerous people and carry out Satan's work. They are very few, but they are in positions of power. Time for them to be brought to justice. Non-humans. They look exactly like humans, but they can shape-shift. It is another very dangerous group in carrying out the plan of the negative alien agenda. What is negative core? Their basic intentions, people with negative core, are all negative and dark. They are good looks, friendly nature, sometimes even helpful, are all a front to trap you. Now, this is a large group. I call them negative thinkers. These are ordinary people. The man in the street, the ordinary John, Jim, Elizabeth, or whatever, but they are a huge problem due to being easily brainwashed, full of fear, easily possessed by spirits and demons, and they derail the good work done by light workers. They propagate negative effects via the mechanism of the 100 monkey effect. They are actually the worst people to have around. Humans with no soul. These are just empty shells of people, vulnerable to be possessed by spirits, negative entities, demons, at any time. And they can even be called zombies. Then I have the term called awakened humans. These people now realize they had been lied to by their governments, medical experts, politicians, big pharmaceutical companies, and even by their own religious institutions. They realize now that religions divide and never unite the people. They now fight for their rights. So, having known these definitions, we shall now dive straight into the esoteric stats. Here now is the statistics for Malaysia. Now, I did a set of investigations on the 13th of March, 2022, before my group of friends set up the Pillars of Light, because I want to know what are the baseline percentages in the following categories. Almost 2 weeks later, on the 22nd or 26th of March, I did another set of investigations, meditations, and connections, and I got these figures. Now let's compare. The amount of light workers in Malaysia is only 0.1%. And it remains at 0.1% of the population 2 weeks later. the percentage of those with dark souls is 11.1%. And after the setting up of the light pillars, it came down to 9.4%. And I take this as not too very significant, really. The amount of non-humans present in the country is the same at 5.3%, while those with negative core intent was 84.4%, and 2 weeks later came down to 78.4%, and I take this as significant. So there's some progress. Negative thinkers, there were 58.4%, and it reduces down to 52.2%. This is another significant result. Humans with no soul is roughly about the same. Now, ascension is a very huge word, and it's very hard to pinpoint the timeline of ascension. But from my figures and from my investigations, actually, the first wave has already been established. So, successful percentage of population who have ascended to the fifth dimension is 2.2%. And 2 weeks later, there was another increase to 4.3%, which I take it as significant. However, those who remain in the third dimensional world of karma and dog-eat-dog kind of world has gone up to 88.3%. And the number of awakened humans remains pretty much the same. So I was curious then to know about some of the countries. So now let me, oh yeah, the accuracy of these investigations is at 88%. So anything above or anything below 80%, according to most of our light workers' standards, cannot be accepted. So this has gone above 80 and is 88% accurate with distortions of 0.3 at the first level and 0.1% at the second level, which is pretty good. And the number of pillars installed in Malaysia is total of 14, while I detected up to 31 in the entire world. Now, the minimum plasma light required for ascension is now about 65%. It used to be a requirement of 90%, but I do not know why the requirement has gone down, which is actually good news. So now this is a comparative study between the four countries, Malaysia, Australia, Norway, and Indonesia. Malaysia having a population of about 32 million, Australia is about 27 or 25.7 million, Norway is 5.4 million, and Indonesia is 273.5 million. These are official statistics from the countries for the year 2021. As you can see, the percentage of light workers is almost similar, but is significantly more in Indonesia, which is a surprising fact to me. The amount of dark souls across every country is pretty much the same. And Norway has the least among these four countries at 1.3%. Therefore, it's actually safer to live in Norway, perhaps less crimes as well. The number of percentage of non-humans is pretty much the same in Australia, Norway, and Indonesia. But wow, there are about 5.3% of non-humans in Malaysia. So non-humans presence means there are a lot of darkness, hidden agendas, and other stuff. Those with a negative core intent is highest in Malaysia, 78.4%. And the least in Norway. And comparing Malaysia and Indonesia, which is similar in so many aspects, it's so surprising that Indonesia has only 8.4% of its population with negative core intent. This group of negative thinkers, as I've already said, are the dangerous ones, of course, as are these and these and these. But these are the one that propagate and support the negative agendas. It's 52.2% in Malaysia, pretty high in Australia at 58%, and Norway 3.2% and Indonesia at 14.3%. So, Australians, please know, you gotta change, and Malaysians, we gotta change the number of negative thinkers. We gotta give them information, share information, share truth and not lies, propagate truth to awaken this group of people up. They're ordinary folks, but they can be very dangerous because they project that negativity. Finally, humans with no soul. Pretty much the same across here, Australia, Norway, and Indonesia, but it's so high in my country, Malaysia. So therefore, you can see the state of affairs by just knowing these percentages. Wow, let's call the first wave, ascension wave, the first wave. And I detected those who have successfully ascended to the fifth dimension is highest at 24.3% in Norway. And the rest about pretty much the same here, but Australia is among the least in these four countries. Now, here is another very interesting data. I compared to those who have successfully ascended to the fifth dimension between people who have been vaxxed against the COVID and the non-vaxxed. You can see across the board here, in Australia, in Norway and in Indonesia, it's pretty much the same. And a little bit higher in Malaysia. But look at those population who have not been, who have not taken the vaccine. They are almost twice the numbers in their respective countries. So this is another note to take care about, and it corresponds with the knowledge that most of us light workers have about the effects, the unseen effects of the vaccine. At the moment, the percentage of population that remain in the three-dimensional world, which is collapsing, the timelines are merging, collapsing, and it will be disaster. The highest remaining is in Malaysia with about 88% still living in the three-dimensional world of all the negativity that they can think of. And the percentage of awakened people in their respective countries pretty much the same, except this is funny because for Norway, it's only about 4% of people are awakened. And I think this really shows it because there are still a lot of people in Norway who don't believe in truth, who get conned easily by disinformation. And there's a sizable number of them in Norway. And the most here is surprising, very surprising, shown in Indonesian population of awakened humans. And therefore you can see that that's why they are progressive. Their policies are conducive for tourism, for business, for economy, for harmony. Now, I was interested to know the number of cabal influence people in their countries. And we have only about 0.2% here. It is not zero. While Norway stands out as among these four countries as having about 8% of the cabal in among their population. Actually, it's not surprising to me because the intel that I get about Norway is, although it's like a peaceful, quiet country, it's got a lot of underground military bases. There are a lot of NATO bases and military bases there in Norway, which few people outside really knows. So this wraps up my short presentation about these special percentages of the population data, rather than the usual statistics of what you can find in any website or government website. So I thank you, people, for listening up to this level till almost the end of my video. And just people from these four countries, take note of the areas that you need to improve. And then we will see you next time. And by the way, if you are a new viewer to my video, please subscribe and hit the notification bell and help to recommend this video so that more people will come to know these very, very special energy statistics, which I believe almost like nobody else had it. I appreciate your time, and I want to thank and say to all of you, take good care, be safe, be a positive thinker, make use of the 100th monkey effect positively, and God bless all. And those who need healing, you may contact me. Thank you. Thank you very much. And we'll meet again. So once again, blessings to all. And you need advice, counseling, special healing to connect with me. Or bye.